distinguished guest, Attorney Teresa Catherine Arcua, our school director and directress, Mr. and Mrs. Antonio Arpundalant Sr., our school principal, Mrs. Maria Zaire A. Calalay, our administrative officer, Mrs. Darlene M. Arcal, parents, teachers, and students, a pleasant afternoon. Today, we have gathered here to celebrate the most precious event of this school year, 2021 to 2022, the 24th commencement exercises with the theme K-12 graduates, pursuing dreams and fostering resilience in the face of adversity. This is Sharon Angeli M. Narad, your host for today's ceremony. Let us give thanks to the Lord, the giver of life through a prayer, to be led by Sheena Wesley E. De La Rosa, Grade 6 Perseverance Pupil, followed by the singing of the Philippine National Anthem.
Let us hold our hands, close our eyes, and bow our heads, and feel the presence of the Lord, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear God, today we join in heaven as we celebrate and give thanks for every student here. Thank you that each one is unique and brimming with potential. Thank you for leading them in their learning, for keeping them safe as they studied, and for watching over them in their final requirements. We pray that they may all feel proud this day and enjoy sharing their achievements with family and friends. May today be a memory that burns bright within them as they embark on life's great adventure. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Bayang mag-iniw, perlas ng silanganan, alam ng puso sa dibdib mo'y buhay. Lupang hinirang, guyan ka ng mag-iting, sa mandulupig, di ka pasisiin, sa lagat at bundok, sa simoy at sa langit mong bukha, may dilagang tula at awit sa paglayang minamahal. Ang kisap ng watawa,
for the singing of ADTMS hymn, here is the ADTMS faculty choir.
Victory.
Before we further proceed, let us watch and cherish our beloved ADT Mians as they navigated the new way of teaching and learning.
In March 2020, the world was taken aback by the sudden lockdown due to the pandemic caused by COVID-19. Our lives were severely affected in all ways possible, from the huge number of COVID-19 cases to the closure of establishments and businesses and the almost unending community quarantines. Subsequently, this global crisis challenged the flexibility and adaptability of our educational system, which led to a major shift in education. Fortunately, despite all of these overwhelming consequences, ADT Montessori School stood strong on its grounds as it strives to continue the school's vision to move forward and adapt to the educational landscape in the creation of the new normal to produce God-loving, productive, resilient, dignified, self-reliant, and patriotic citizens of the country. Furthermore, the school stayed true to its philosophy, reformatting schooling, creating and transitioning into a new normal through nurturing a learning environment that will produce 21st century learners. Along with the shift in education from traditional face-to-face classes to online and modular distance learning, major changes and adjustments were implemented on the part of students, teachers, school officials, and other stakeholders. With this, ADTMS made sure that the frontliners in education, the teachers, are well trained in handling online and modular distance learning, equipped with new technology-based teaching learning strategies, and empowered with passionate drive to impart essential knowledge to students, even in this unprecedented time. Moreover, the students, parents, and guardians were also required to make adjustments in order to make learning at home possible. For the past 2 years that we were forced to adapt in this remote teaching learning environment, we have seen how dedicated everyone in this institution in making sure that the education being delivered to students are still of high quality that will further help them in their educational endeavors. Indeed, ADT Montessori School continues to become the oasis of students in getting the treasure of knowledge, wisdom, and love, even in the midst of this arduous pandemic. The battle to pursue learning is still a long way for this institution. And as we walk on this path, let us work together and build on this experience to continuously improve our educational setup that will be the foundation of creating a brighter future for every ADT Mian.
Truly that the pandemic brought a huge change in our school, yet it stood still and strong to continue in providing us quality education. I am both honored and delighted to present to you the hard-working faculty members and administration of ADT Montessori School.
The Board of Trustees. The Administrators. The Administrative Staff. The Department Coordinators. The high school department, the grade 7 advisors, the grade 8 advisors, the grade 9 advisors, the grade 10 advisors, the subject teachers, the middle school department, the grade 4 advisors, the grade 5 advisors, the grade 6 advisors, the subject teachers, the primary school department, the grade 1 advisors, the grade 2 advisors, the grade 3 advisors, and the preschool department.
At this juncture, may I present to you Maria Reina Isha A. Cruz, grade 6 temperance pupil, to deliver the welcome remarks.
To our honorable guest, to our school director and directress, Mr. and Mrs. Antonio Dangilita Di Punsalan, to our school principal, Mrs. Maria Zaide A. Kalalay, our administrative officer, Mrs. Darlene M. Arcal, proud parents, faculty and staff, fellow graduates, a blessed day. On behalf of Class 2022, it is with heartfelt gratitude that I welcome you all here at ATT Montessori School to celebrate the graduation ceremony of the school year 2021 to 2022. The challenges and hardships we hurdled have paid off. We survived! Yes, we made it. I would like to congratulate my fellow graduates who stood tall despite the tribulation that tests their faith and capacity as a student and as an individual outside the institution. After 6 long years of striving hard in our elementary years, we are now ready to harvest the fruit of our labor. We would not be here if we didn't overcome those struggles and face head-on the challenges. The 2 years of the pandemic made us more flexible and better versions of ourselves. Now is the time that we pay tribute and express our unending and deepest gratitude to our parents who brought us to this remarkable institution. And of course, to our teachers and administrators who unwaveringly taught and supported us all the way. To my beloved ADTMS, indeed, you are our oasis. Thank you for nurturing us to be the best that we could be. To my fellow graduates, let us continue to strive hard. Success does not depend on what ranks or awards we receive. We have a long way to go. Let us be ready to conquer and take on this world. With these sincere words, I, Maria Reina Isha A. Cruz, joining you in this wondrous experience. Once again, welcome to this graduation ceremony.
Thank you, Maria Reina Isha, for that earnest words of welcome. Now, may I present to you our school directress, Mrs. Angelita D. Punsalan, to give us a heartwarming message.
A pleasant day to all. Today, we celebrate the fruits of our labor, your graduation. It is indeed a time to be happy and thankful for having survived the turmoil brought about by this pandemic, COVID-19. And emerge triumphant in your studies. Congratulations! Your resilience and perseverance made the success possible. Keep up the good work. Continue your journey to your future. More challenges are coming up your way, but your readiness and intelligence to handle these difficulties would surely keep you through. Never give up. Try and try until you reach your goal. Do not forget to trust God. Pray. He will take charge of things you cannot control. Remember to keep your feet on the ground. There is peace in humility. So be humble. To you, our dear parents, accept our heartfelt gratitude for entrusting to us a part of your children's future. Your untiring support inspired us to keep on striving for perfection and achieve our goal of quality education for our students, your children. Thank you. Thank you. I hope we're able to meet your expectations. Again, congratulations. God bless us all.
We appreciate deeply your encouraging message, Mrs. Pundalan. Thank you. This time, let us listen to Mrs. Maria Zaide A. Kalalay, our school principal, to give us her uplifting message.
Our estimable guest, one of ADTMA's accomplished alumni, the Board of Trustees of ADT Montessori School, Mr. and Mrs. Antonio R. Punzalan Sr., Ms. Teresa P. Tiongzan, Mr. Antonio D. Punzalan Jr., and Ms. Daisy P. Villanueva, the school director and directress, our administrative officer, Ms. Darlene M. Arcal, the administrative staff, faculty, parents, beloved candidates for graduation and completion, a felicitous day. I am completely awed that today you are finally partaking in this momentous ceremony. That 2 years of arduous and humdrum new way of learning was just formidable. Yet, despite the Herculean task that you had, trying to get by the day-to-day monotony of interacting to the moving head on your computer screens, you pulled it through. This is a manifestation of your grit and flexibility. Today, we are trumpeting your laurels. Hooray to you, our ADTMians. However, after this moment's ceremony lies the greater bivouac of life. To our precious little angels, the kindergarten, your talents and potentials will be nurtured as you enter the grade school life. For our grade 6 students, you will finally be walking on our high school corridors. High school life, a happier stage as they say, yet also more challenging and laborious. Finally, our jewels, my beloved grade 10, it is with confidence that I say, go and spread your wings. When you fail, stand. When you fail again, stand again. Rise from the ashes and soar like the mythical phoenix. In today's rapidly changing world, we need a shield. We need a weapon in order to survive and thrive. First, persevere. Do persevere in the face of adversities and obstacles. Value your studies because education will lead you to the right path and soar to greater heights. The second weapon is passion. Benjamin Disraeli said that man is only great when he acts from passion. My dear students, be passionate on what you do. When you're passionate, you are able to give your best because it unleashes your creativity. Lastly, but the most vital is prayer. In this VUCA world, volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous, our greatest weapon is prayer. Have an unwavering faith that we have an all-knowing, an omnipresent creator, the source of all wisdom and strength. To our precious students, make this 3 P's, perseverance, passion, and prayer, as your compass as you navigate the waves of life. To the very supportive parents and guardians, you deserve praises and homage. I salute your hard work and determination to send your children to school, even in the midst of these very difficult times. To all my colleagues, we struggled and wrestled with a sudden shift in the educational milieu. However, with our teamwork, our love for children, and acknowledging divine intervention, there is nothing we cannot surmount. My dear students, let me leave you with the Ade Timian's mantra. Life is what you make it. So go and conquer the life that you want through your perseverance, passion, and prayer. Congratulations, our Ade Timians. May the odds be on your favor.
Thank you very much, Ms. Zaide, for your emboldening words. To introduce our honorable guest speaker, may I present to you Angel N. Damasino, Grade 6 Prudence Pupil.
Our school director, Mr. Antonio Arbunzalan Sr., to our school directress, Mrs. Angelita D. Bunzalan, to our school principal, Mrs. Maria Zaide A. Calabay, to our school administrative officer, Mrs. Darlene M. Arcal, proud parents, teachers, and students, a blight summary. This duty of introducing our honorable guest speaker is a great privilege. I feel jubilant to introduce her to everyone today because her name echoes the essence of erudite and excellence. Our guest speaker is an alumna of our beloved ADT Montessori School. During her elementary days, she was diligent and deeply committed in her studies. It is no wonder that she pulled it off and graduated with flying colors. She is a graduate of Bachelor of Arts major in Political Science, cum laude, at the University of the Philippines in Manila. Because of her insatiable thirst for knowledge, she then took Juris Doctor at Arellano University School of Law. Indeed, it was not a surprise when she triumphantly passed the Philippine Bar Examination 2020 to 2021. At this point, she is accomplishing a lot in her work, serving and exercising her passion as an associate at Kapunan, Tamano, Javier, Bay, and Associates. Finally, she is also a very fascinating and knowledgeable person, and we're all in for a treat today. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming our very own ADT Timian Pride and our benevolent guest speaker, Attorney Teresa Catherine R. Cua.
To the parents, teachers, and to my fellow Edithanians, good day. It is such an honor to be given the opportunity to speak before all of you. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you for finishing the school year despite all the challenges, changes, and trials you had to face with the online classes, modules, lockdowns that has become a dread not only to the teachers but also to the students. I myself was able to experience this while reviewing and taking the bar during the pandemic. And all I want to say to all of you is to be a bird. Bird as in B-I-R-D. B is for believing. Believing yourself that you can soar high to achieve your dreams. Before anyone else, you need to believe in yourself and what you can do. ADT has helped me to become who I am now because of the teachers who saw the potential in me and believed in me. ADT gave me the chance to explore my potential. As a trivia, we are the first batch to join the journalism competition under the tutelage of then-principal Mrs. Rivera. At first, I did not see the potential in me that I could be good in writing. I even made excuses not to attend trainings. But their trust in my potential made a difference. I tried and luckily was able to win third place in the district level under the news writing category and first place in the division level under the same category. With this, I realized that I can, not only because of the people that believed in me, but also because I believed in myself. Now, if B is for believing, I is for improving. Believe in yourself that you can keep on improving to become better versions of yourself. Your version now is okay, but do know that you have more potential waiting for you to explore. Do not settle in your safe space and always keep on trying to be better versions of yourself. As I have told you, I was in journalism during my elementary days. During my high school days, my teacher told me that he saw the potential in me to be a debater. At first, like most of you, I was scared because my newfound talent was in writing. And we all know that writing and speaking are two different fields. But I wanted to improve myself, not only in writing, but also in speaking. So I decided to join debate competitions. I went out of my comfort zone and tried debating, which helped me improve not only my public speaking, but also my critical thinking. Now, after believing, improving, R is for resiliency. In line with this year's theme, pursuing dream and fostering resilience in the face of adversity. Honestly speaking, in life, things do not always go the way we want it to be. Failures, losses, trials, and disappointments are part of the journey in reaching your dream. But think of it this way. If we are able to easily achieve what we want in life, whether it is your dream school, dream course, or your dream toy or games, would we value it that much if we got it easily compared to when we work really hard to finally achieve what we want? Okay, now to our last letter. If B is for believing, I is for improving, R is for resiliency, D is for do not give up. In connection with resiliency, do not give up. As cliche as it may sound, please, 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 do not give up on your dreams. Trying something really new is scary. Whether it is entering a new school year where we're all scared that we might not know anyone from that section, or choosing your strand or course in college, it is really scary. Like for me, in entering college, I was really scared in entering the University of the Philippines, Manila, because I was the only one of my friends who got in that school. Some of them went to UP Diliman or in UP Dos Baños or in other universities. But despite being really scary, I tried and persisted. And to this day, I could say it was one of the greatest choices I made. Some of you may feel really tired after accomplishing a lot of modules and projects while being stuck at home, not being able to physically see, talk, and play with your classmates and friends, which is perfectly valid. I want to remind all of you that it is okay to pause, but please, never stop. For me, especially when I was reviewing for the bar, my pattern was to wake up around 5 a.m., open my books, study, and my only breaks are to eat or to take 15-minute naps, and I would study until around 11 p.m. However, there would really just come days when you feel so tired of the continuous cycle of just studying. And what would I do is close my books, go for a walk, or watch a feel-good movie, or even just take a day off. Then you will try again. I want to remind everyone that in life, it is not always about how many times you have succeeded, but also how many times you kept on trying despite everything. So with that, I want all of you to soar high like a bird. Keep on B for believing, I for improving yourselves to reach your dream, and stay R, resilient, despite all the challenges you face, and D for do not give up on your dreams and aspirations. Again, congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Attorney Teresa, for that uplifting and dignifying message. And now, I would like to present our school register, Mrs. Daisy P. Villanueva, to present the candidates for graduation, our school principal, Mrs. Maria Zaide A. Kalalay, for the certification, and of course, our school directress, Mrs. Angelita D. Punzalang, for the confirmation.
Mrs. Maria Zaide A. Kalalay, school principal of ADT Montessori School Incorporated, I would like to present to you 41 boys and 51 girls, a total of 92 grade 6 students, as candidates for graduation this school year 2021-2022.
Mrs. Angelita D. Punzalan, school directress, ADT Montessori School. Based on the presentation made by Mrs. Daisy P. Villanueva, school registrar, that these 92 grade 6 candidates for graduation, composed of 41 boys and 51 girls, have successfully complied with all the requirements of the enhanced K-12 basic education curriculum prescribed by the Department of Education for all private elementary schools under the Republic of the Philippines. May I therefore request the acceptance and confirmation of their graduation this school year 2021-2022.
Mrs. Maria Saide A. Kalalay, school principal of ADT Montessori School, as the school directress of this school, I am honored to accept and confirm the graduation of these 41 boys and 51 girls for a total of 92 grade 6 students who have satisfactorily complied with all the requirements of the enhanced K-12 basic education curriculum prescribed by the Department of Education for all private elementary schools under the Republic of the Philippines.
This is a momentous occasion for students to reap the fruits of their labor and the time to at last receive that most coveted piece of paper, the diploma. And so, ladies and gentlemen, the distribution of diplomas and awarding of awards and certificate. To introduce the graduates, let us have the advisors of grade 6 level.
These are the graduates of Grade 6 Perseverance for school year 2021-2022. Kobe Chrissy Amasio, Mark Carlo M. Anda, EJ DG Canta with honors, Shino Wesley E. De La Rosa with high honors, Justine B. Gumabon, Shander Oz D. Javier Ulit, Nico Angelo R. Laurio with honors, Asher Angelo Magsino, Rance Dominic D. Medino, Carl Jerome L. Pancho with honors, Maderick Marco F. Pinote with honors, Justine Caleb R. Santos with honors, Miko L. Tayamin, Joaquim Andres D. Chu, Samuel G. Tolentino, Agatha Mirela A. Bundalian, Jamie Carmiel S. Centeno with honors, Audrey Micaela B. Cuya with honors, Angela Christelle C. De La Cruz, Tia Margaret D. De La Cruz, Athena E. Enahe, Sophia Andriana C. Gaerlan, Sophia Jaira E. Garay, with honors. Princess Myra F. Garnosa. Zaira Gail M. Labudlay. Bella Felice M. Malapad, with honors. Janaya Akira S. Pilias. Iris Zentiche J. Salcedo, with honors. Ayesa Marie F. Tapukol. And Ariel Gianna M. Tejares. Congratulations!
These are the graduates of Grade 6 Prudence for school year 2021 to 2022.
Justin Clark V. Bacol, with honors. Zachary B. Bernardo, with honors. Wayne Ruel R. Contilio. Kirtley T. Deborah, with honors. Owen Gabriel A. De Guzman. Kramer Thomas S. Holiganga. Ethan Carl N. Lipa, with honors. Gabriel Luis V. Salise. Marcos Isante Taule. Liam D. Tauro. Enzo Zemarian O. Victorino. Isaiah Justin G. Wasan. Jasmine Gaya T. Arenas, with high honors. Melisabel D. Cero. Angel N. Damasino, with high honors. Emerald E. Donasco, with honors. Hazel Shane R. Imata, with honors. Christine Emmanuel G. Flores. Daniel Sofia U. Gabinete. Mary Prudence Gallegos, with honors. Cleo Monique M. Gargoles, with honors. Annika Kim J. Hermones, with honors. Elise Joan Levis. Carla Avelia E. Marquez, with honors. Amber Nair V. Ocampo. Altea Joy A. Purgis. Kate Ashley B. Santos. Jade Antoinette B. Ukol, with honors. Caitlin Chloe D. Valeroso. And Nisa Jara D. Villaflor, with honors.
Congratulations! These are the graduates of Grade 6 Temperance for school year 2021 to 2022.
Edric James F. Balane. Kurt Bradley H. Borella. Carlo Adi DJ Cabantin, with honors. Andrew James M. Catalunya, with honors. Jose Benedict C. Cordero, with honors. Justine R. C. Eroles. Ezequiel Joaquin T. Flores, with honors. Jairo Mikael E. Focanan, with high honors. Fernando P. Garcia Jr., with honors. Sean Brile S. Hoson. Paulo Mikael B. Makalalad. Ezequiel Jasper C. Olea. Jacob Hendrix M. Shobal. John Kyle C. Tabilia, with honors. Leila Francesca J. Amparo. Cassandra Chloe G. Arvis, with honors. Precious Micah G. Besmanos. Kiara E. Calliao, with high honors. Makea Aldrich O. Capumpon. Albiela Gracie G. Cruz, with honors. Maria Raina Isha A. Cruz, with high honors. Janelle Azel B. Quaresma, with honors. Adavian Christy M. Dizon, with high honors. Jalina Noraine N. Gaela, with honors. Luis Chloe G. Hipolito. Johanna Ira P. Lantong, with honors. Altea Sofia V. Loyola. Cassandra Jeriel G. Montas. Salacia Ray S. Padernal, with honors. Megan Janina N. Pinca. Gilan B. Razon. And Katrina Charis M. Solares. Congratulations!
Once again, congratulations, graduates! At this moment, may I present Jasmine Gaya T. Arenas, Grade 6 Prudence Pupil, to deliver her words of gratitude.
To our school director and directress, Mr. and Mrs. Antonio R. Puncelan Sr., our school principal, Mrs. Maria Zaide A. Calalay, our administrative officer, Mrs. Darlene M. Arcal, to the faculty and staff of ADT Montessori School, our beloved parents, friends, and to my fellow graduates, greetings! We are all gathered here today to be a part of this special event. Together, we celebrated our achievements and recognitions, the fruit of our labor. We have just ended a long chapter in our lives, which is middle school. Now, we are about to begin with another chapter of our journey, high school. Once again, we have conquered the challenges brought by the new normal. COVID-19 came into our lives without warning, yet we still succeeded in getting the better of it. We have proven that with the right mindset, we can overcome any trials and hardships. I strongly believe that the people who had faith in us and helped unleash our full potential are cheering with us right now. We have made it this far because of the people who willingly volunteered in guiding us to the right path. They are the ones endlessly wishing for us to have a good life. Parents, we thank you for continuously being with us throughout our journey. We are grateful that you worked hard for us so we can carry on with learning. Your love and care for us motivated us to strive harder in school and in improving our morals. Teachers, we thank you for devoting your time and energy in educating us about valuable lessons. Your dedication is greatly appreciated. We will forever cherish our moments together and all your lessons that will serve as our guide to being better individuals. Classmates, thank you for studying alongside us. You played a big part in giving school life its spark. Thank you for all the lovely memories, and I hope you all have the strength for high school. To the ADTMS administration, I cannot stress this enough how blessed we are to have you support us in our education during these past 6 years without complaint. We have no doubt that you will continue to be accommodating for years to come. Dr. Florentina R. Lozano, we thank you for being by our side during our learning experience at ADTMS. You will always be in our thoughts and forever in our hearts. And to our Almighty Father God, we thank you for always watching over us and for giving us direction, purpose, and perseverance. We couldn't have reached this far if we didn't carry on working hard. Let us all give ourselves a pat on the back for being strong. The best way for us to show our gratitude is to make the most of all the opportunities handed to us. Congratulations to all of us!
Thank you so much, Jasmine! As we are nearing the end of this significant event, here is our middle school department coordinator, Mrs. Edna Medalia D.L. Hermojedo, to give us the closing remarks.
To our school director, Mr. Antonio R. Punsalan Sr. To our school directress, Mrs. Angelita D. Punsalan. To our school principal, Mrs. Maria Saide A. Kalalay. To our school administrative officer, Mrs. Darlene M. Arcal. To our guest speaker, to my fellow teachers, our beloved parents and pupils, a blessed day, everyone. I take great pleasure in congratulating you all in this very memorable event of your lives. This day is not the end of reaching your goals, but this is another starting point of striving more and pursuing more to be the best that you can be. With your perseverance and diligence, you are able to cope and adapt the 2 long years of our online distance learning. Today, you are now reaping the fruits of your labor. I salute you. Keep on going because you are all in the right track. Think about all aspects that brought you here. All the trials and failures. All the nights of study. All the fun and fulfilling experiences and great learnings. Make all of this as your anchor as you steer the next chapter of your lives, the junior high school. My dear students, let us also give gratitude and congratulate your parents who supported you all the way. And of course, let us not forget the very hardworking ADTMS teachers, the staff, and the administration who have served as our compass during this adversity. We owe them our deepest gratitude and appreciation. Another door awaits you with lots of challenges, new and fun learnings. I know that you can all do it. This amazing accomplishment is just one step on your journey. Always continue to soar high and follow your dreams. Once again, congratulations!
Thank you, Teacher Edna, for your touching message. Now, to reminisce the times that we had during our challenging online classes, let us all watch the videos of the class of 2021 to 2022.
Ako'y nagpapasalamat sa lahat ng sumabay sa paglalakbay. Papatungo sa aking pangarap, lagi ko kayong tanaw sa paglipad.
Sabi nila di ko raw kaya, lang mapapala, wala raw pag-asa. Bukang bibig ng madlay, puro panggagaya. Pero salamat sa lahat ng naniwala.
Naniwala, nawala, lahat ng pangamba. Nagsimula, magmula nung makasama ka. Di ko na kailangan pa ng iba.
Halika, may sikreto ako, atin natin lang.
Sige!
Na mo ba di makakaya nang wala ka? Yeah! Walang makakatumba sa atin kahit ano pa mang halaga.
Ako'y nagpapasalamat,
thanks,
sa lahat ng sumabay sa paglalakbay. Kung patungo sa aking pangarap,
hey,
lagi ko kayong tanaw sa paglipat.
Ako'y nagpapasalamat,
thanks,
sa mga naniwala sa aking abilidad. Sa pagkatang ko na banayad,
hey,
tatanawin ko kayo sa aking paglipat.
Sa lamat sa, salamat sa, lamat, thank you very much. Sa lamat sa, salamat sa, lamat, thank you very much.
Please lang huwag ka nang umalis, love, kasi lagi-lagi na kitang namimiss lang. Parang di nagbayad 1-2-3 hanggang peace lang. Dapat paramihin mo ng 6 yung 3 para unlimited.
Ang samahan ng hanggan kahit pasukulan ng mga karanasan.
Walang di kayang lagpasan
kahit pasan ako ay lagi mong pasan.
Minsan may bardagulan,
labing siyang pagwalang,
labing
walong mga kayamanan niya nang dahilan ng matamis na karanasan. Kahit pa umulan ng kamalasan, di ko na namalayan kasi lagi ka na riyan, yeah. Ako'y nagpapasalamat,
thanks,
sa lahat ng sumabay sa paglalakbay ko patungo sa aking pangarap,
hey.
Lagi ko kayong tanaw sa paglipad.
Ako'y nagpapasalamat,
thanks, sa mga naniwala sa aking abilidad. Sa pagkabang ko na banayad,
hey,
tatanawin ko kayo sa aking paglipad.
So, salamat sa, salamat sa, salamat, thank you very much. Salamat sa, salamat sa, salamat, thank you very much.
Palagi mama hobya, di ka nagsasawa. SLM tinakuha mo ba ikaw yung ka?
Palagi mama hobya, di ka nagsasawa. SLM tinang sobra, mahal lima, mahal ka ng lima.
Graduates, continue to soar high and reach your dreams. This has been your Master of Ceremony, Sharon Angeli M. Nadad. God bless everyone!